best friend in my car. And guess what it is? A Subaru Forester.
All right, now I'm off to Melbourne. Getting used to the Subaru so far. I'm struggling with the turn signal because it's on the other side of the steering wheel.
Back.
Then I found the legendary Australian Pink Lakes, and you can kind of see it.
It'll see better with the drone in the sky. Bring her up!
Wow, that was some of the highest wind speeds I've ever flown in. The drone was really struggling, and I didn't even realize there was a power line going across the lake.
On the way back, I looked up instead of looking at the screen, and then I saw it, and then I looked back at the screen, and it was like right in front of the drone where I had stopped the drone. That was intense, and hopefully it came out better on the drone camera, because from here, the pink part is pretty far away. We are off to a fantastic start.
Look at that. Wow.
There we go, that's better. Oh, I can smell the ocean. I love it. And it's actually the ocean this time, not salty bore water. Probably no drones allowed, but we'll do it anyways.
Shot for the FPV drone, I stumbled upon this old anchor that found at the bottom of this little cavern area here. That's pretty cool. And a little bit further down, found some old buoys right up ahead there.
Well, there was no sign saying no drone, so it was all legal. Hopefully I got some good shots of it. I don't have a way of charging my drones on the go, so I'm trying to use them as little as possible. Usually I load up the batteries with footage and then choose the best, but it's just one-shot wonders, hopefully. But now I'm just gonna do the rest of the walk. Pretty awesome.
had to do some weird origami stuff to get down that cliff. But I've made it to the arch, and there's a lighthouse in the background. Can't get better than that. Well, I went down that walkway a bit more, and it just goes on for a long ways. And I haven't put sunscreen on yet, and I'm also getting really hot. So I think instead of doing the walk, I'm gonna go to the beach and take a dip. I just realized that you can drive on this beach, so that's exactly what we're gonna do. Agreement. There are tons of dragonflies here. It's very weird. The water was pretty cold for it being summer in Australia, but we are at the south, so this is the coldest part of the country. I guess cold's not the word. Cool. It's the coolest part of the country. It's pretty boring without friends. Without anyone at all. There's a couple girls out there that I just talked to briefly, but it was a very one-sided conversation, so I left. I'm not sure what my plans will be from here. I've got 3 days to do this trip, and I have to time everything well so I have a place to stay and stuff overnight. I don't know. I haven't quite figured this out yet, but it seems to be a popular thing to have rows of trees, like perfect rows. Just keeps on going endlessly. These rows aren't as organized as others I've seen, but I guess maybe this is a Australian version of a tree farm, except it's a lot more specific. Whereas tree farms in the States, they just kind of rope off a forest and let it grow, do whatever. But this, I think these are specifically planted, maybe even the type of tree as well. They all seem very straight, maybe for telephone poles or something. But they are everywhere. I am now in Mount Gambier. It is nearing the end of the day. I'm gonna get some dinner and do some video editing and plan tomorrow. I'm thinking of, there's some things around here that I wanna do here in Mount Gambier. And then I hopefully have enough time to do stuff in the mountain range, which is the next step. And then end the day at Warrnambool or something, which is near 12 Apostles. 12 Apostles is the main purpose of this whole trip. It's rock formation on the side of the cliffs down the road, and I'd like to time it so I could be there for sunrise, because that would be epic. So hopefully I can do the stuff here as well as stuff in the mountain ranges. The mountain range wasn't originally part of my plan. It was just gonna be a straight shot to 12 Apostles from here, but Jesse, the pilot at Bulgania, recommended the mountains for me, and I was too obsessed with the ocean to think of it before, but I could use a refreshing set of mountains. It's kind of hilly here. It said there's a mountain view in the description of this room. Yeah, kind of. A very industrialized mountain. And this is a motel, not a hostel, so I've got a really nice bed, really nice pillows. I love YHA, but the pillows that I had over the weekend, those were just, it was like sleeping on bags of cement. It was pretty bad. Now this is what I like to see. This they don't do in many places, where they have a bunch of outlets available for you right at your bedside table.
I always have to like pull out the bed and stick an extension cord in there and plug in my phone and stuff. So that's nice.
A cool thing about this bathroom is you have a dispenser for hand soap, butt and body lotion, shaving cream, and in the shower you got shampoo, conditioner, and shower gel. I'm assuming that's the equivalent of soap. That's advanced.